Yeah, I noticed yesterday when Eric Walt was talking about the education system, you were listening in, and, you know, it's specifically on that topic.
I was drawn to Eric because it was very obvious that he thinks for himself, mm-hmm. and he comes up with his own ideas, and he doesn't just read something other people have said. And I, almost topic after topic after topic, I come up with the same things myself without reading anyone else. I talk to education groups, and I tell them, you know, when you start to school, you go to kindergarten. And, you know, first day my kid went to kindergarten, he wanted to kind of look and see what was in the drawers. Oh, they said, no, you can't open the drawers. You can't open any of these drawers. You can only do what everyone else is doing at that time. And it's like they start stunting you. You have an idea. I can do something in the world. You're taught, no, 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 no. You can only follow this one little labyrinth
right.
maze. You have to go on the same track as everyone else. And I've also come up with this whole idea, you know, that matched what he said, that intelligence in our schools is defined as always having the same answer as everyone else. You go home, you watch the same news show, you come back and talk about current events, mm-hmm. you all say the same thing. And not one person says, no, that doesn't make sense to me. Not one person is really taught to think for themselves, or that's called not intelligence. We're taught how to calculate when two canoes will meet on a river. The river's flowing 5 miles an hour. You know, and we should teach kids to raise their hand and say, no, that wouldn't work, because you can't predict the water will be exactly 5 miles an hour. There's going to be wind and... You know, why don't we you know, think about these things, be skeptical a bit. We don't really teach that way. We just teach come up with the same answer that everyone else would. Well, then you're just one in a billion.
But isn't that kind of controversial?
That's like being a follower instead of a leader.
Isn't that kind of controversial, though? Isn't that kind of controversial to do the opposite of what everybody else has done?
Well, I think, well, some schools, like Montessori schools, get around, you know, do some better job at that. But, you know, our whole system of schools is unfortunately very bad because it's based on money, mm-hmm. and money, especially in a democracy, you got a problem. Schools all are funded by the government. They're all funded by the government. And government has slices of pie that go into different sectors, usually according to how much money there is there or how many votes. Well, the funny thing is, for schools, kids don't get a vote. What that translates to is a family of five gets no more say than a family of two. And the family of two doesn't want to spend money on schools. And the family of five does. So you've got this controversy where you're constantly outvoted by the masses. You didn't really, the kids don't get counted as a vote in the, you know, determining how much money schools are worth and need. So schools are always going to be short of money. Short of money, it means you have to have a large class and everybody doing the same thing, and you can't have any randomness.
Well,
you know, and I think randomness and even a little misbehavior is really essential to creative people.
Well, Steve, I was a kid that had a 4.0 GPA. I followed the system, the rules to the T. Everything I did perfectly. Obviously, I'm being sarcastic with you. I had a 1.0 GPA. I failed most of my classes except math. I love math. I could listen to that stuff all day long.